Hello, this is Michelle Knight. Welcome to your weekly astrology. This week, we have an amazing full moon in Cancer. And the full moon in Cancer teaches us how to nurture. It's emotional, it's intense, and it's reminding you to look after your beautiful self. Here's your weekly astrology. Pisces, you wonderful, divine and beautiful energy. This week is the start of a new era. Well, it already began on the 21st, actually. And you're opening up to your magic and your power. And this full moon is potentially could bring you a lot of joy, but it's certainly going to focus you on what you need to be truly fulfilled and happy. There is a peak experience. And hopefully for some of you, you'll get a peak experience of joy and be laughing your head off and having a great time or feeling really creatively inspired. But for others of you, if you're not feeling happy at the moment, it could exacerbate those emotions and you might be feeling not quite yourself. But you know, as a magical being, that the moon will always give you a message on what you need to do. It will give you a dream, a sign, a symbol, a strange coincidence that brings to your awareness the answer that you are seeking. So it is time to use your imagination, to use your magical powers that you naturally have. And even if you don't believe me, I believe that you do have those magical powers. You're a Pisces. It is the most magical sign of them all. So what do you need? What do you desire? What makes your joy flow? What makes your creativity flow? What opens your heart to love? These are the questions you will be experiencing and answering this week. And just before that, actually, the sun is trine Uranus on the 28th. There's a spark of conversation and opportunity where you're going to feel plugged into the mains, in a good way, plugged into the mains with your connection. You may decide to suddenly get this brilliant idea because Uranus always brings us a spark of genius or a surprise that we can use in a positive way to put something out there in the world, or to do something online, or to join forces with a wonderful like-minded souls, and you feel inspired and excited. Now, with the full moon, I have to say, Venus is squaring Neptune, your ruler in your sign, obviously. So that could be bringing up a lot of self-doubt connected to your career or connected to who you see yourself in the world. Also, Venus is opposing the North Node, and it's the message of that is to nurture yourself and to create a future structure from today based on you feeling secure and nurtured and having healthy dynamics with your family. And of course, family isn't just blood relatives, it's who we consider our family. Now, you may be saying, well, there ain't no chance of that because there is a lot of dysfunction in my family, Michelle. But you will be given the answer. You need to nurture yourself. You need to have that peace and tranquility, and you will find a way forward. But don't be hoodwinked by anyone this week, because that square with your ruler, well, actually, it might be at the time quite pleasurable. You know, you fall into a lovely little fantasy world and you dream sweet dreams. So I'm not too worried about it, but don't kind of, you know, commit to anything until you're sure what is real. And then, of course, go for it. And this year has so much potential for you to come into your power and your magic. It is worth doing. Let us see what the tarot has to say. Every single other sign has pulled the Knight of Cups at some point. Now, interesting to see if you get it or not. But even if you don't get it, I've said that I think it's the energy of this moon trying to gently open us up and offering us wisdom. Let's have a look. Pisces. What is occurring? Oh, lovely. The Ace of Wands. And this kind of relates to the full moon energy. Passion, potency, achievement, life force and energy is around you this week. And a peak of that energy. An ace is pretty good going for the first week of the year. And also look out for an Aries, Leo or Sagittarius who's in their power and is greeting you in an equal way. You're also feeling quite spontaneous. You might leap into something. Now that's good, but remember, you know, the square to Neptune may not reveal everything straight away, but it is good to open your heart and trust and dive into new experiences, particularly as you've got the Ace of Wands there, you're covered. The Queen of Swords, you may be talking to someone and they're talking to you from a sort of detached way, or perhaps you're talking to someone and you're detaching your emotions, or you're very focused on the job in hand. Well, that's good. I'm not going to complain about that. That's excellent. You're working really hard. Trust yourself that you're moving forward. Take care, gorgeous, and I'll speak to you soon.
MichelleKnight.com. I was a client of Michelle Knight, so I knew all of the psychics and they'd read for me.
It's such a innovative and really useful organisation to have at your fingertips.
There are a lot of people who, they have an idea of what a psychic reading is, they have an idea of, you know, what a psychic should and shouldn't do, and a lot of it is from centuries gone by, you know, the carnival sideshow. And Michelle really has brought psychics into the modern world.
Michelle Knight is a wonderful organisation to work for. It's a unique family. And that is readers, the customer service operators.
I know if I wanted to choose a reading, I know I wouldn't go to another company.
Beneath the ethics, the standard, the professionalism that we keep really is second to none.
To be honest, I've never really looked at another reader service because I don't think I need to.
When I finally got the job, I pray that I will do well with all the tests that we go through. I was absolutely delighted.
Well, the process of being employed with Michelle Knight wasn't an easy one, which is always makes it more rewarding when you do actually pass the four test readings that you have to go through before you're accepted.
The interview process is actually reading for other people, reading for some of Michelle's staff as well. It's actually, you know, what they're looking for, specifics, so surname, relatives, their names. They're looking for what happened 2-3 years ago in detail.
To be sitting at home and then the phone rings and this beautiful distinctive voice, it's Michelle Knight here, I'm ringing you for my test reading, is on the other end of the line, is scary. She really wants to know that her clients are getting validations.
You get a sense that everybody running it is on the ball.
The flexibility we get as readers, well, it's just great.
I do love the freedom of when I can work and when I can have a break.
Michelle Knight family are amazing, really flexible, very supportive. It's like working for no other.
It's authentic, that's a big thing, it's authentic. She genuinely cares about her readers and about the people that we read for, so it's inclusive.
I love working for MichelleKnight.com. They're great people, it's a great energy there.
She really cares about her readers getting the best, and she really cares about the clients coming and walking away, you know, and feeling like they got what they came for.
Working with Michelle Knight, I know that I've got professional backup and I know that the clients are looked after very well as well.
Michelle's very involved with her readers personally. If you need information, you need anything from her, she will reply personally.
I just love being part of a unique team, one of the most unique companies that I've ever come across.